When you think of Scandinavia and the colder northern regions, one of the first things you might think of is an igloo. This type of accommodation is world famous in this part of the globe. So today, I want to bring you with me on a tour of a luxury glass igloo in Finland. On top of the quick tour, there are some other fun activities in the area, like hanging out with some local animals, some nighttime snowmobiling, and another episode of Mike doing really dumb stuff when it's cold outside. So without further ado, let's hop into this week's video. Welcome to my igloo, guys. Igloo number 20, which is Vjotos. Each igloo has its own name. I am so pumped to finally have the opportunity to stay in an igloo. This is a world famous type of accommodation that definitely first got its start here in Scandinavia. There are igloos everywhere. That's one of the main reasons I flew all the way across the pond from America to come to stay in an igloo. So let's hop on inside, guys, and we will start the igloo tour. Okay, welcome to my igloo, guys. So as soon as you step inside to this beautiful little igloo, it's very easy to organize and use all the space given to you. They have this great little closet right here. I thought was pretty surprising is, again, the igloo is not huge property or huge accommodation. They still managed to fit in basically almost a full kitchen right here. So you got two burners right here, you have a sink, then bottom left over here is your fridge, microwave, and these are just two more areas for dishes and all that stuff. So again, I love Scandinavia. The architects, the designers do such a great job of utilizing what may not look like a ton of space to just tons of different cabinets and just useful amenities for the guests. So this is what I would call kind of just the entryway, the mudroom, but now let's head into the bathroom, which again is not huge, but I love the design of it. So when you walk in right here, I mean, pretty self-explanatory. We have your shower stall right here, toilet, and then yours truly with the mirror. But right behind me, as we may not expect again for something of this size, you actually have your own private sauna inside of your igloo. So it can probably fit about 2-3 people max into this. It takes about 20 minutes to heat up. I will definitely be in here like every night before bed and then take a shower after. So really nice, again, little private sauna so you don't have to share with anybody else. So those are the two kind of first rooms you see when you come into the igloo. Now let's get to the part I know you guys most excited about, which is the actual igloo part and all those views. So for starters up, before we get to this main section, I just want to show off this one super cool feature. They actually have heated windows. So you flip this switch and then you set the temperature right down here. And as you can see right here, this is the first part of the window. All the snow is dripping off, because that was one of my first thoughts I had when I knew I was gonna be staying in an igloo. I was like, all right, that's cool, but it snows all the time in this part of the world. It's just gonna cover the igloo, and like, how can I see it? Like, am I gonna have to go and like shovel off the window every hour? Like, that's gonna suck. And no, they have window heating. So quick little side note there, super cool amenity. But now let's enter into the main area, obviously my favorite part, which is the igloo. So this is the part right here, guys. We have a cute little table and get some work done. You can have your meals, but this is the igloo, guys. Look how big these window panes are. They are absolutely huge. They go up top too, obviously for viewing the northern lights. And then right down there is this gigantic lake that all these igloos sit on. So really, really trying to go all the way back to show you guys wide open space here, looking out into the lake. I thought it was super cool. They actually have like a compass right here. So north, south, east, west, and north is this way. Where I'm pointing the camera is where the northern lights would appear if we do end up getting lucky on this trip. So that is the main igloo part. These are the two beds. They both come in both king size and twin size beds here at this accommodation. There's kind of two other finishing touches over there in the corner. So there you go, guys. There's number 20 at Arctic Fox Igloos. Now I think we're gonna go do another fun activity to seal off our day here at the resort. Let's get to it.
After finishing up exploring around the igloos, it was time to do some activities in the nearby area. To kick off our activities, we first start at the zoo where we saw a polar bear, which was quite a sight, and actually the Arctic fox. We even got to feed this little guy.
There you go, buddy.
Damn, that was quick. Get it down.
After the zoo, we did another round of huskies. The difference being this time, I actually got to steer the sled. My favorite activity, though, would have to by far be riding a fat bike. I've seen fat bikes all over social media. I never once thought I would get the chance to actually do it for myself. Riding a fat bike is way, way harder than it looks. You basically have to have amazing balance and you're constantly battling against the snow. It made out to be quite an amazing leg day workout for me. So after finishing up all along the trails around our igloo, we then headed back for a much, much colder activity in the nearby lake.
Welcome back to another episode of Mike Doing Dumb Stuff When It's Cold Outside. On today's episode,
we are going swimming in the freaking frozen lake. They have carved out a section of the lake right here, and I'm gonna go for a very, very quick dip, but the water also looks like kind of brown. And I have no idea why, but I'm gonna make this quick, guys. Let's go for a dip in the lake.
Oh boy. Oh boy.
Holy. Oh crap. All right, this is as deep as it gets. Holy sh! Woo! Holy crap, that's cold! Oh. All right, I need a hot shower.
Holy sh!
For our last activity, we did a nighttime snowmobile expedition. Our guide was a super cool dude, and he took us to the middle of the woods and built a campfire for us, and we enjoyed some local Finnish drinks and food right over the fire. And although the Northern Lights didn't come out that night, we were still treated to a sky full of stars, and the Northern Lights finally came out for the first time on this trip for me the next night when we were staying at an Airbnb. Here's some blurry pictures of myself as proof it's impossible with the shutter speed. Thanks for watching, and I will see you next week.